Hello students, welcome back again. In our last lecture we had discussed about the asexual modes of reproduction among the different organisms. Now I am going to start with our next two topics, that is vegetative reproduction and the sexual reproduction. So before we start with this topic, first I want to make you clarify that what is the difference between vegetative and asexual mode of reproduction. Because normally the people think that vegetative and asexual is one and same thing, but actually these two terms are entirely different. Asexual means when the organisms is producing some special structures like zoospores, conidia, that we have discussed in our last lecture. And vegetative reproduction is one in which no special structures are produced. That means the any part of the plant, because this is especially in case of plants. So any part of the plant that reproduces through the stem, root or the leaves, that method is called as the vegetative mode of reproduction. I'm repeating it again. Asexual means some special structures are produced, whereas in vegetative, no special structures are produced. Here zoospores, conidia, such type of structures are formed, whereas here stem, root and leaves, these only participate in the mode of reproduction. So now let's discuss in detail about the different modes of vegetative propagation or reproduction among the plants. So some of the common methods are, the first one is runners. As the name indicates that the plant, it run over the surface of the ground as it is shown over here in this picture. And the very common example is the grasses. And I hope you might have done this thing while sitting in the ground. You all might have uprooted the grass and you have seen that when you start uprooting the grass, it seems like that it is running on the surface of the ground. So that is why they are called as the runners. And the common example is the grasses. Second is the rhizomes. Rhizome is an underground stem which is located parallel to the surface of the ground, and the best example is ginger. This is in a picture of a rhizome where the rhizomes are lying below the surface of the soil and they are running parallel to the surface of the soil. So these all are the rhizomes which can propagate to give rise to the new plant body. Next one is the suckers. So in case of suckers, the new plant arises from the main stem at some distance. So you can see, look over here in this picture, that at a small distance, another stem is arising from the main stem. And the best example is mint, that you all have seen that mint, it keep on increasing over there from one point to the another and so on, that it will spread in an area within a very short duration. Now the next one is the tubers, and I hope you all are familiar with the tubers because we all are doing it from our junior section, and the best example is potato. Just now focus on the definition. These are the underground swollen tips of the stem. Here the part swollen is only the tip part. The rest of the stem is not being swollen. So that type of stem or underground part is called as the tubers. And the best example, we will have the potato, which grow under the soil and used as in a mode of reproduction for the new plants. Now the next one is the offsets. Offsets are the one internodal long stem. It is in case of the aquatic plants. And the best example is Aishonia. This is in a picture of Aishonia. And you all have seen this plant growing in the water body. And now this plant body has become one of a great aquatic weed. It has dominated the entire plant body, sorry, entire water bodies. And Aishonia, the tragic story related with the Aishonia is there, that it was introduced in India for its beautiful flowers, but now it has completely dominated the all the water bodies, and this is popularly known as the terror of Bengal, because in case of Bengal, it was introduced for its flowerification, but gradually it dominated the entire water bodies. It cut short the supply of oxygen to the aquatic organisms and ultimately they will die. The common name of Aishonia is water hyacinth, and commonly also known as the terror of Bengal. Now the next is the, that is the bulbils. So in case of bulbils, these are the short stem with fleshy leaves for the storage of food. These all are the bulbils, and the best example is the onion. where you all have seen at the base of the onion, there is an round stem part is there, which is called as a stem part, and it is surrounded by the fleshy leaves. The part of the onion which we consume, that is actually the fleshy leaves, and the common example is the onion. So this is all about the different type of vegetative reproduction. But the important thing is, here I am discussing only those modes of vegetative reproduction which are mentioned in your NCERT. Otherwise, in other books there are plenty of examples, but we will focus on these examples only, because as per your curriculum only these examples are mentioned, and as well as according to your the NEET exam, board exams, the question will come only from these particular examples only. Now the next is that why algae and fungi, they shift to sexual mode of reproduction during the unfavorable conditions. So these plants normally they reproduce asexually during the favorable period, because these organisms, algae and fungi, they need water and food to multiply. So they multiply very easily during the rainy season, during the other period when there is humidity is higher. They reproduce at a very fast rate, but they shift to the sexual mode of reproduction during the unfavorable, that means during the summer, when there is no humidity, water content is less. So these organisms, they shift to the sexual mode of reproduction, and this question normally asked in your board exam. The reason is that the combination of genes, because during the sexual mode of reproduction the gametes will fuse, so these genes, they increases the vigor of the organism to face the adverse conditions. And the second important thing is, there the haploid organisms, they will become diploid, and the diploid organisms will have more strength to overcome the unfavorable period. Variations arises over there which help them to overcome the unfavorable, and again on the return of the favorable conditions they will give rise to the new plant bodies. So this is all about concluding. I am concluding this all in this video only, and the next part of this I'll send you in the next video.